Hi, this is, well, this is this video I'm gonna dedicate this, and it's a video response to the latest. Hi, I'm Miguel, Michael in Spanish, Miguel or Miguel. I live in Miami, Florida, and I want to thank you, Yoko, from Random Yoko in your other channel about your forgiveness of what you have said to Korean people. You know, the Dear Korean People video, I not just like the video, I love it. I love it. And let me tell you why I love it. It's because when I saw your video, and then your previous two videos about the annexation and about the thing that I might not agree, but I did a video about comfort women, but you did video, you know what? Nobody's perfect. People in Korea felt wrong, you know, and I said this. And I will tell you something, what my personal opinion, you know what it is? Look, if you don't know about me, of what have happened, yeah. I have lived in Miami, Florida, almost at the same time since you were a baby. Well, and one of those things that I say, well, I could tell you my interest. I love watching football or American football. My favorite American football team is the Miami Dolphins. Look at this, Miami Dolphins, right? Property of the Dolphins. Yeah, that's their former logo. Their new logo is kind of different now. I kind of like it now. It's different, but I was like reading something, and I will tell you what it is. My dream that I want to reality, and I have always want this. Even though there's so many challenges for me in this life. And life is full of challenges sometimes to stay up, and you know, I miss these magic opportunities. But yes, you know what? I think I am not my sister. And my dream is like this. One thing I do admire is my cousins. My cousins did what they did. They married people that are totally different than me, or different than them. You know, we come from Latin background, you know, white Spanish background, Spanish speaking country. My parents are from Colombia, but I could tell you something. Two of my cousins have black spouses. And I don't mind that. Why? Because there's something I am interested of. My male cousin is married to a black girl. He's married to a black woman from Jamaica. And they have children and they love each other. My other cousin, my female cousin, she is married to a black guy. And she has children with him also. Me, you know what is my interest? My interest in my life and what I want in my life, Yoko, from Random Yoko, is that I want to marry a Japanese girl. I want to be the first one in my family to be married to a Japanese girl. I mean, married a Japanese woman, you know. I want a Japanese girlfriend. And I'm trying to learn your language. Your former native language, Japanese. You know, I know some words. Konnichiwa, genki desu ka? Ohayou gozaimasu. Arigato. Arigato gozaimasu. Yeah, just some few words. And I'm really seem interesting that, let me tell you why. When at first I was more like, you know what? What's the reason of this? Even though I have never seen what it is, you know, I wanted to talk to you. And back then, I never knew. But later on, I knew in life, I read something about, like, you know, encyclopedia about Japan. It seems like a beautiful country, a beautiful culture. I have never experienced, but, you know, but these people that I talk to, they're very awesome. I have been to a festival, but not in the United States. But, you know, I just remember that day. These people are very... I'm just seeing that I have somebody who is sick. But these people are very warm, family-oriented, good morals. Similar to our Latin culture. Quite different of way of expressing yourselves, right? So, if I wanted to talk to you, Yoko, from Random Yoko, I think you have a name, your name after one of the band members from the Beatles' wife. You know, you heard about John Lennon. Your name after one of his wife, after his wife's name, right? And your brother. I could tell you, your brother has a girlfriend who was named after Donald Trump. Yeah. Yeah, your brother's... I could imagine that your brother's girlfriend, Yoko, is named after Donald Trump's first wife. I think I met her. Yeah. She was a cool person, too. She could help me out when I was in... this school called Florida Career College that I never got a job in my field of study. Yeah. But I was reading this thing, and let me tell you one thing I will say. You know what? Doesn't matter what people bash to, or they bash your country, or they bash my parents' country. You know what? Let me tell you, ask. I love Japan. I love Japan so much that I never even been there, even just noticing the people. You know, when I was in Canada, there was a Japanese festival over there when I went to with my step cousin, or, you know, a relative of my stepdad. And then I say, so that's what I tell you why your people from Japan are very warm-hearted people. Very family oriented, you know what it is. Similar to what I was saying is you people express differently what it is, because you're like family. You stick to family. What matters to you the most. So different than here. Way different than here. Gosh, this is like Japan is more. It's like a more organized version of Latin America. Going to that, you know, organization plus family matters. You know, I never read this. I read this magazine about, you know, comes to going places. It's about Tokyo. Yeah, and it's talking about Mount Fuji and talking about the ideas of, you know, of Senshuji's temple. They talk about Shichu Market, the Shichu Market in Tokyo, Japan, and how Japan is what is amazing about Tokyo. You know, the Shichu Market is like one of the markets that they sell fish and stuff. It's very awesome. How is, like, you go to the Ginza Strip and all that stuff. Pretty amazing about Tokyo, Japan. Yeah, Tokyo's awesome. You know, it's an awesome country. What's so amazing about it is that I could tell you this. If I wanted to go there, I think I could risk it. You know, the only risk is saying, like I said, is like, you know, I not even know the language. If I learn the language, just staying there, right? You know, so there is a risk in things. Your former boyfriend Matt, you know, I think he left because I think he's homesick, and he knows what he's gonna do, and he's homesick plus, you know, used to live in New York, or he went back to New York, right? But when I find out some things about what it is in Miami, Florida, doesn't have this community, but what I learned about Japan Day, you find out on the internet, Yoko from Random Yoko, Japan Day is a festival that comes out in May, and every May at Central Park, a certain date in May, they were gonna celebrate Japan Day, the history and culture of Japan, you know, because I think people love Japan. Well, not all Japanese people are good, but I could tell you that, and not all American people are bad either. What we have done, and what I think, you know, what I think about one thing about the Koreans are so jealous or anything. It's so sad. It makes me cry. It makes me sad that they say you guys deserve it. You know what? It's our own fault. It is so sad about it. I feel so bad, even though I was born in the US. I feel so bad that my own country has done so much wrong. And I say they've done so much wrong because they did it. And they didn't know. They didn't know what's going on. And plus, what is so ridiculous is that they even killed people of my own faith. Look, I am raised Catholic. You know, and Nagasaki is one of the most Catholic cities in Japan. And they nuke it. It's terrible. You know? And then the reason why is God tell them to love one another, you know, and I need to practice that. And then you come up with this thing. Your songs are like the annexation song was more important about it, is that they underappreciate what Japan has done, right? They underappreciate what Japan has done, and they only focus on the negative, and they try to bash, and then they call you some names and stuff. Darn, you expressing your own self. You know, if these people don't know what it is saying to be good Christians, because they say to be, you know, there are Catholic churches too in Korea founded by Japanese missionaries. And they are like underappreciated, you know what it is, and what it is about my denomination, about this priest, pedophile priest. If I say to understand, the Vatican didn't know or appreciate all the details because it's having closed doors about pedophile priest in South Korea. How they sexually abuse kids, and then I find out that I made a video of being patriotic, and then that is where I did from the Universal Man 002 channel. And I wonder if you watched it, you could watch it, and you could give my opinion if you could agree with me in this kind of thing. You know, we are proud, or I am proud of where I am. We are proud of so many things that it is. You know, it's like this. It's ridiculous. Some people saying Michael Jackson is a child abuser. Like he molested kids. Yeah. I'm just not gonna like that kind of thing. Saying the video, like you said about Psy. You know, it's good to be proud of what you are. And also I know where you're from, and let's say I'm proud of my own roots and stuff, even though they're gonna bash Colombians, oh, they're drug dealers and all that stuff. No, it's not that. And what I will tell you things about things is that we have, in the United States, we celebrate something that when people had ran off from religious persecution from the pilgrims came here in Plymouth Rock to celebrate Thanksgiving, to thank God for like being survived, for not being prosecuted. And then we serve the turkey and we serve everything. And then I think that if you come here, we could be friends. We could hang out and stuff like friends, right? I need to know you. I think you are beautiful and talented, and you are a very caring person. What I wanted to do too is that I know that I will actually be is do something for charity or for stewardship at the church that I go to. It is about doing something for Fukushima victims. People that are still suffering from the Fukushima area, donate money, donate clothing, or people in need over there from here to over there. I think it could be amazing. Maybe in the festival that we have every time Spring Festival comes in February, I think the money should go into that. And that should help Mother of Our Redeemer helping the victims in Fukushima, Japan. That'd be awesome. And that's my idea of what I thought. Well, example that it, what it is that I know there's so many things that is going on right now in this world. You said about, in your video about you're not gonna help them or cut diplomatic alliances, whatever. Okay. Let me tell you something. If there's things about things, I know there's this politician that he wanted to run for president. His name is Ron Paul. If Ron Paul was president, I don't like to say that, and I hate to say it, like he wanted a better diplomatic relations with other countries. Probably for diplomatic relations with Japan for a certain island. I hate to say this. If Ron Paul were president by now, we already had a war with China already for an island. We already have gone to war. The United States has gone to war with China for just an island, just to protect you guys. And maybe it's like you said, they're bad enough without cutting this diplomatic relations with Japan. You know what? Even though the United States has helped Korea, then with Ron Paul was president, Korea is gonna be totally screwed because we're gonna cut ties with us to have stronger relations with Japan. Isn't that right? And you know what happened? They're gonna bash America. People in China and Korea are gonna start burning American flags. And let me tell you why. Because if Ron Paul were president, having better foreign relations, and for not us to sink down better foreign relations with the US and Japan means flag burning in China and Korea. That's the one thing I don't want to see, but you gotta be careful what's going on with this, Yoko. But as you said, you're right. They'll be bad without Japan, but they'll be totally screwed without the United States. It's like if I'm using this phone, the phone that I'm going to use recording there is not gonna be a Galaxy S4. It's gonna be either a iPhone or a Sony Xperia phone or a Motorola phone or something, Because what would happen if Ron Paul were president, right? And we have more American goods being bought here and all that stuff, if Ron Paul were president and sees how to fix the problem, and then if Ron Paul were president, P over there people in Seoul might start putting lighter fluid in an American flag just to torch it. But thank God, in that sense, that Ron Paul is not a president, Barack Obama's the president now, and we never get to see American flags being torched in South Korea. So that's my point of view. If things going in your way, things could be better with the U.S. and Japan have stronger relations. First of all, Yoko, I'm actually want to see if you come here as friends, and I want you to know that I do like is one of if not so, this is crazy, but on Facebook I like a Japanese chick. Somebody 10 years younger than me, old enough as my stepbrother. I mean, 11 years younger than me. Well, her name is Mai. I'm not talking about Mai from the Mai log. Mai from the Mai log. I remember her. I used to like her before, but not anymore. I don't know if I started to like you. You're beautiful and talented, Yoko, but one thing is that we need to meet each other. And please do me a favor. You know Facebook, right? I'm trying to be your friend, and I wanted to delete one of my accounts from Facebook. You try to block me in chat into two channels. Please do me a favor. You have to unblock me because in Embargo Man and Universal Man 002, and I have priorities, and you could have helped me with this. I wanted to learn Japanese, even though there's not enough a big enough Japanese community. It's just zero. This is in New York, this ain't California, this ain't Hawaii. But also, I wanted to put myself as a DJ, starting here in Miami, Florida. My stepbrother, he knows how to do this. His name is Fuego Beats. And I tried to do so many things that, I write songs for one. All I did is did when I was overseas, when I was out of the United States, all I did is I wrote two songs for a girl, for one woman. And I could tell you what it is. Okay? Her name is Mai Koyanagi. She used to go to school in Canada, and then she went back to Japan. She lives in your hometown, Yoko. And let me tell you this. Tokyo is like three times bigger than New York City. It's like Japan's New York. It's like we call it's like New York is America's Tokyo, right? Somebody's calling. Well, it's like saying Fukuoka. Have I read about your town? Well, it says a sister city's Atlanta. I know they have beaches and stuff and everything. Momoshi Beach and I think we should have to be related with Miami. You have a station in Hakata, that you have shops and restaurants and other stuff. We have a train station in the metro rail called Dadeland South, where you go to a mall, and plus you go and go in shorties, and you could eat awesome barbecue ribs. Awesome barbecue ribs. So what I want you to do is, like, if you are serious about this, please unblock me if there's a favor, if there's like you could contact with this woman, with this young lady, you know. As I would say, I don't know if she works at the same company my brother does, my stepbrother, I mean, in generally, in other words, consider him as my brother. Maybe Mai could work she might work for ADP. ADP is one of those companies that they sponsor paychecks and do programs for dealerships and stuff. I think ADP is from the US and they are in Japan. You know, maybe I don't know if she's in New York. But as she said, she wanted to go to New York and stuff, and I talked to her on Skype. You know, I like her. I do really like her. But if we could be friends, if I could be friends with her and all that stuff, you know, I think if she did found someone, you know, I think we could start and know each other and share our cultural differences. You know, I might go into South America. My dad lives in Colombia, and I think what you have done in your videos, somebody's watching. What I've done in your videos is something that is, and I know it's a long ass, very long ass video, Yoko. It's like if you've done something about Korean women being prostitutes or something. And then you have this misconception of comfort women. You know, it's like me in one of your videos, somebody's crying. You know who cried in that video? You know who cried watching this video? It was somebody that I had on my first crush. It was an Asian lady, but she is not Japanese. The person who was crying is Christina. I think it's Christina Bradford, probably because she is adopted. She is crying is because of one of your videos. That's why Christina's crying. Because it's like me. If you do this about all of them doing prostitution and sort of, it's like me saying, making a video. Oh, Christina is the chick that she is fake, and I see her in Biscayne Boulevard selling her body for making a buck. Well, Biscayne Boulevard here in Miami, Florida, is the section where you find prostitutes. You know, it's like saying, you know what? It's like you doing the same thing with one of your videos. Come on. You know, understand this, that you gotta love one another is like in form of the basic form principles of Christianity. Love one another. People died for us. He died for our wrongdoings and stuff. That's the honor of what I believe who founded Christianity, and probably you might be interested, you know. But I could tell you one thing, Yoko. I could tell you one thing. Even though my mom called me, just watching for you, I'm kidding. Even though, Yoko, if you wanted to do this, I am saying. Well, what I'm saying is like, you is like somebody's watching your video. It's like, you know, my mom's telling me to go watch the game, whatever it goes. I'm here. And I'm talking to you, Yoko. I'm not doing something wrong. It's like you have to change your mind. You have to change the ways, or you have to agree with me on some things, or I could share opinions. It's your opinion. I respect your opinion, but sometimes there are opinions that hurt other people, right? It's like, as you have said, they come out to be, with one of your songs, they come out to be something else. That these Korean hookers come. I could tell you what, if there will be anything right now, I think we should go to Nevada. In Nevada, the state of Nevada here in the United States, prostitution is legal. in some parts of Nevada. So if you have mind to understand where to go, supposedly the state of Nevada might have the first female Asian American governor. And she come out, oh yeah, she's this woman that work at the China dollhouse in some part of Nevada, and she is Korean American, right? That's just saying that you've proved something, that you want to just find out some things that you don't even know about, and yes, if there is, I find out in Nevada there is no nothing. There is no place called the China Dollhouse or the Geisha Ranch. It's like somebody come, oh yeah, let's go to the Geisha Ranch or something like that. As like you said in your video, they pretend to be Japanese, even though they might pretend to be Chinese also, for what's the matter of fact. If you could say, if you could prove something about the only legal state in the United States, because I live in Florida, called Nevada, and trying to hurt people, find out of this. I don't know if we could do something about going into all the whorehouses in Nevada and ask every Asian whore, see if they're and have lying detector tests and all that stuff. Someday to pretend to be to have Japanese names and working in these illegal places in Nevada, keep on with their BS that they're not even from Japan, but they're from Korea and they work at these legal places. Ask them if they could lie, if they're telling the truth or anything. And then if you prove this right, if you prove it to me, if we go to Nevada, and I ain't gonna do this, I ain't gonna spend money on a hooker. I ain't gonna touch every hooker because I know that they might get things and and this is unmoral. This is so unmoral to be with a hooker, it's against my own morals or against our own principles. Because it's immorality, it's not right. And so what it is, I think you and me, or we could meet each other. I think you could bring my Koyanagi here, and all the other things that I'm talking about this, please tell her that I am not a bad person. I'm just trying to say nonsense on Facebook that she might not mind. We don't deserve 9/11, and these punks are like bad. And let me tell you who started this. And you talking about GHQ? You know what? Let me tell you what happened with Saddam Hussein. And I don't agree with the Iraq War. The Iraq War with Saddam Hussein, I tell you something, there's the same people that you talk about GHQ, the same people are of GHQ, like something similar to GHQ, are in Iraq. They're the ones that have killed Saddam Hussein. Then these guys have their own government, like seeing America sided. Even if that's what happened, if Ron Paul were president, he would end up this kind of crap, in Japan, and on the occupation and all that stuff, like I want to tell you about. Other than that, I think we could meet each other, and I know that you and me could be great friends and have awesome ideas, and we could share different things to talk about. So I would say thank you very much. Sayonara. And arigato gozaimasu. I would say goodbye, Yoko, and see you for your video response to my video. Thank you so much, and thank you because I appreciate it. Even though Christina's watching your video, she's shedding a little bit of tears, and she thought she's a good person, even though she's Korean. She's a good person. Even thought she will be very grateful and thankful for Grant and probably loves you, and she might think of going to Japan. I want to go to Japan also. Goodbye.